unforeseen circumstances. Am I talking to anybody up in here? Unforeseen people working against you. Unforeseen coworker coming and got bad babies. Unforeseen things going on with family members. Can I talk before school today? Unforeseen things that people just come out of the blue and pick you out to pick on. Unforeseen. Unforeseen church of that team that won't want to act right on Sunday. There's always going to be things that's going to try to work your stress level. Whether it be finances, whether it be relationship. Hello. And then somebody said, neighbor, relationships can really get to you. And that's why in 2017 you're going to have to cut the cord. I want to be real, transparent, is that people are dying at a rate now where it's alarming, and you can't even hardly keep up because so many people are leaving here, and you sometimes wonder, am I going to be next? On when your name is going to fall in the death list. And that's why you need to do it by any means necessary to relieve yourself. Touch your neighbors and neighbors. Relieve yourself of stress. For 2017, that whatever we had to put up with and deal with in 2016, we cut the cord. Shake a neighbor's hand like you've been scared of them and say, neighbor, 2016 will not cross over with me tonight. Now folks in here right now that you get quick, you get angry, mad in a minute. You'll flare up in a flash. There's never been such a time in this bishop where we got so many Christians growing. Facebook this week of people that's dying from everywhere. Yes, yes. Everywhere you turn around, everywhere you say, Lord, don't let me be next.
Lord, don't let me be next.
The Bible says that that God gives us riches and prosperity. The blessing of the Lord make us rich and added no sorrow to it. Just want to give you something a little simple that's going to carry you through 2017. Because a lot of us pastors are allowing ministry to stress us out.
Jesus.
I've learned that you can't make folk come to church. And I'm talking to you can't make folk live right. The most you can do is preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. And they can choose to live or die. God said, preach the gospel to every creature, in season, out of season. But what he did not say, pastors, is stress out.
He didn't say that.
We can get very emotional. I'm talking to us leaders now. We can get very emotional when it comes down to ministry, because ministry is the passion of our heart. You started to impart in people's lives, to lead people out of darkness into the marvelous light. We pray, we call on our knees. When they don't know what we're calling to, we are praying. They don't understand what it takes to be a leader. I'm just talking a little bit to the leaders. And yet we get so emotional involved in ministry that when things don't go the way that we prayed about, sometimes it pushes us to a place. We got to be very careful how we handle disappointment. We got to be very careful how we receive people from the negative. Arms of flesh is going to fail us.
Yes.
And will fail us.
Yes.
And oftentimes we put too much confidence in people.
Uh-huh.
And less confidence in God.
Yeah.
Can I be real? Can I be real? We need to prepare ourselves just in case folks fail us.
Yeah.
So that the church won't be affected by naysayers. And folks that say, if I ain't come, there ain't nobody gonna do nothing. If I'm not gonna open worship and pray, they'll be stuck. Throw your hands in the air just like you don't care. Shout wrong. My mother used to tell me, Minister Turner, that one monkey don't stop a show. I come old school a little bit where if they don't show, I can carry on. You cannot allow people to hinder your progress. I just want to talk a little bit. I want to talk just a little bit. I'm about to quit. I'm just trying to prepare us for 2017, because something good is just over the horizon that's going to blow your mind. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, get ready for mind-blowing experience. He works on biblical principles.
Yes, yes.
And whatever goes down, the Bible individual is right and somebody's wrong. I'm just talking. I just want you to get the proper perspective to understand that lifesaver lies within the word of God.
Amen.
If you don't know nothing else to do, pick up your Bible and read it. On God or pray until we get interested in the truth. Let's be real. Pastors don't hear from folks sometimes, all the time, a long time, until their whole family get in trouble.
Right.
I say that. You have to be very careful, young people. You have to be very careful because suicide rate. It's not just in the world, but it's in the church. And pastors are committing suicide because they can't take it. Somehow the enemy have infiltrated and made them think God don't hear them no more. You are in a very bad position when you get to the place that the same gospel of Jesus Christ that you've been preaching, now you have come to an ultimate conclusion that the Bible don't work no more. Over the last few years, there's been many pastors that have committed suicide. One man of God that never expected to come back to second service. Everybody waited for him. And he was in the yard in his car. Put a bullet in his head. That God don't work no longer. That God is not true to his word. You got to understand that when a preacher commits suicide, that means that the level of stress has taken over. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I'm not going to let stress take me over. Not gonna let, listen, you got to be very blunt with people who are in your circle. You got to be very straight up if you're in a relationship where it's taking so much out of you just to maintain. Some relationship is just too much maintenance involved. Anybody can feel it. Anybody got enemies to rain. The mortician needs to go back home. The grave digger needs to call up the grave because that's not for me. With it, it's nothing. Tell the neighbor, say, neighbor, my stress can't go with me no more.